Welcome back to the channel, guys. It's been a while since I brought a laptop review over here, but Lenovo has recently sent over their newer ThinkPad Z13 here, and I spent about a month with this, and it was a great little laptop, so I wanted to put together a little review here for you, so let's go ahead and get into it. For our general specs here, we do have the 8-core APU here from AMD, the Ryzen 7 Pro 6850U with integrated 680M graphics. We've got 16GB of soldered-on LPDDR5 RAM, the 512GB PCI Express Gen 4 SSD, Wi-Fi 6E, and Bluetooth 5.2, so a pretty decent little package for this form factor here, and we'll take a closer look at how that's performing. Now we've also got the ThinkPad's typical keyboard here. This is a spill-resistant backlit keyboard with that track point, glass haptic track pad with integrated nav buttons, and that metal design with the vegan leather top cover, which we'll talk just a little bit more about here. Now, if you've followed my reviews at all, you know I don't typically like cloth or leather or whatever covers on these because I'm afraid I'll damage them, but I messed with this laptop for about a month and I really didn't have any problems with this. It's a very elegant design for this laptop and it worked really well. Now, on the bottom here, it does gather fingerprints really easily, but not really a big deal on the bottom. We have our air vents there and our downfire speakers, which we'll talk more about. Hinge is typical good for Lenovo for me here, very sturdy and stable even after a good bit of use here. And of course, yes, you can open and close it with one hand. All the weight of this laptop is just sitting right there on the bottom. So a really nice, easy, sleek design here from Lenovo on this small ThinkPad. Now when it comes to ports, there's not a lot to talk about. We have our standard headphone mic jack here, we have our power button, and we have a USB-C port over here. On the other side, we have one USB-C port also used for charging, so you might want a hub if you need to plug in more things. We've also got a 13.3-inch 400-nit 1920x1200 IPS touchscreen here at a 16:10 ratio. Now that 400 nits was actually really good when compared to my 250 and 300 nit laptops, much more usable in the higher lit areas here around the house or even outside a bit. The glossy screen, however, is pretty reflective, but overall the performance of the 60 Hz was nice and smooth and the colors were great when it came to this panel. Now we do have a fingerprint reader right here on the keyboard, which worked great. More importantly though, we do have two built-in mics, two speakers, and a full 1080p webcam with infrared and also a privacy shutter here. So I've got a couple of recordings here for you guys to check out.
So this is the webcam, 1080p 30fps, two mics picking everything up. And if you press the F9 key, you'll get privacy instantly on your shutter. Press F9 again to get it to come back up. So nothing amazing here, but a functional camera.
All right, I came out here to a little bit different lighting, do another camera test here. It's not the best, but I got some sunlight coming in the room. If you had some face lamps on you, you'd be all right. Get down here by the camera. So, you know, it could be better, but it gets the job done for sure. And of course, you still have the F9 you can press for your privacy shutter, and you're good to go there. Now speakers are always a tough one, but I'm in a quiet spot here for the most part, so I'll let you guys check this out. Alright guys, so there you go, if that gives you any indication of the speakers. They actually sound really good in person. It's very hard to get that across in a video. Now the keyboard itself is really nice to use even on this smaller form factor with decent key travel. It feels satisfying to type on. It's maybe not feeling as good as maybe the normal size ThinkPad keyboards do, but for what this is, it was really decent. And using that glass haptic touchpad with the nav buttons integrated, it felt great. This is really smooth, and I like that they went ahead and took up plenty of real estate on this small form factor for the trackpad. Especially someone like me that has kind of larger hands, it's just easier for me to maneuver around. And of course, the track point on the keyboard is working good as usual for Lenovo there. But all in all, keyboard and trackpad were a great experience here. Now I'll go ahead and pull up our battery specs here in the Advantage software, but we're dealing with a 51.5 watt hour battery, and with a fast charge for about an hour, you can get about 50 to 80%. Now I got 7 to 10 hours watching movies at full brightness and speakers at 30%. 8 to 11 hours browsing, emailing, and watching a few YouTube videos, and 1.5 to 3 hours while gaming or doing very high demand tasks. So I think for the most part, that's to be expected with the battery life here, and it was pretty good, especially being a smaller 13-inch laptop. Now, I used Cinebench here, not really for a score or anything. As a matter of fact, I didn't even get a score in this video, but I used it just to kind of see what our performance and our temps and that type of thing are like when we're just kind of running things out full max here. And Cinebench is good for that, especially on the APUs. So anyways, you're going to see those temps of the CPU package bounce up pretty high. I did get all the way up to 100C earlier doing some manual clock speed. So this is just set at everything auto. And you'll see it will start to throttle itself down as we do get higher up there, but it never allows itself to truly get to that 98 to 100C like before. A matter of fact, it slows things down enough here to where it even gets itself down under 90. So you will experience some thermal throttling and leave some performance on the table, but that's what you would expect with a 13-inch laptop running a 6850U. It's not necessarily built to sit there and do high demand tasks for a long time. However, once you're done, it does dissipate the heat pretty quickly and the fans do their job pretty well. So let's take a quick look at some gaming performance. It wouldn't be Game Tech Planet otherwise. And with a Little Heaven benchmark running really smooth on our frame times here and doing what I would expect, it was time to jump into a little bit of game. So we've got Elden Ring at 1080p here, and I'm pretty much running a mix of low and medium now. None of the settings in this video are recommended settings. They're just kind of a baseline for me to see how performance is. And on par is what I expected here for the 6850U for Elden Ring, especially at 1080p. Might do a little better knocking this down to 720p. But that would be the case with any of the games in here that I'm trying out. But for the most part, Elden Ring, a playable, decent experience. I don't think I ever went under 30 FPS, and a lot of the time I could hold higher, and you could tweak the settings a bit more, as I was saying, to get some more out of the game. But we all know Elden Ring isn't necessarily made to run that great on PC anyway. It wasn't a really high frame rate game, but it does run plenty well to play here. Now, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, I also ran at 1080p, another game I would recommend probably dropping down to 720p when it comes to the resolution, just because as you see here, I only used really the benchmark for this, but you're going to kind of hover in the 30s, which is fine. You could even enjoy this game at something like a locked 30 FPS at 1080p, and it'll look really clean, but you could knock things down a little bit. You could do 720p and be a little bit better, but either way, nice to see that the power of the 6850U here was giving us at least clean frame time, so I didn't have a lot of jitter or stutter. So even at lower frame rates, gameplay will still feel pretty smooth if your frame times are nice and clean, which is helpful with an APU like this. So you can see here our final results. We had about an average of 34 FPS with these settings. Now the final game I wanted to take a look at for fun was Splitgate. This game also running at 60 FPS for our target, since our screen is 60 FPS, and I did knock things down just to see if it would make a difference. I had some spikes and weird things going on, and this did help. I feel like I should be able to run everything on high, but anyways, for this, I wanted to go ahead and just knock things down to medium, and it worked pretty well. I still got some spikes here and there, but for the most part, I could get a decent 60 FPS experience here with this game as well, and there's just a ton of games that you would be able to play on this 6850U. This is certainly not a laptop that's necessarily designed for gaming, but you can certainly pull off plenty of gaming with a Ryzen 6850U, and on this laptop, it's no different, other than maybe some thermal throttling and, of course, eating into your battery life. If you're traveling or home or doing business or whatever with this laptop, it is quite an elegant-looking and business-worthy laptop. You'll certainly be able to get in on some gaming. But anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out this video. As always, there'll be links in the description to this laptop and other items if you want to go check this out. Thanks a lot for coming to watch. If you haven't already, thumbs up, ring the bell, subscribe, leave your comments, and I'll see you in the next one.